Throughout the course, I'm going to be developing on the MODX Cloud, which is my favorite hosting. However, you can develop on any hosting that you would like. I'm just going to show you how to set up a MODX account. And in this video, we're going to be installing MODX on the MODX Cloud, which is really easy. But on my next video, I'm going to be doing it manually so you can install it on your own server. So the first thing I want you to go is go to modx.com, and then I want you to click sign up for MODX Cloud. And afterwards, input your information and select the billing plan. Select the cheapest billing plan, because the great thing about the MODX Cloud is that you can have unlimited development servers with URLs. And so you don't have to buy domains every time you need a development server, which is one of the reasons I love MODX so much. And then add your payment plan, and then I'll see you on the next screen. All right, so this is the homepage or your admin panel of the MODX Cloud. And you have various options here. I have organized my sites in groups. And on the top, you have your mini options. You have new cloud, clouds, backups, and snapshots. The MODX Cloud automatically backups your clouds every day and keeps all the backups for 7 days. However, I usually change them for 30 days for sites in production, and I just leave them 7 days for sites in development. Snapshots is when you reuse a template very often. So for example, if you have a MODX blueprint, so instead of like editing the same options every day, all you have to do is, you know, snapshot it and then start the site. I can show you that later on. So what I want you to do is go to new cloud. The only thing I don't like about the MODX Cloud is that it's the admin panel is slow, the user interface isn't so nice, and the text is a little bit too tiny. But you know, after using so many horrible hostings, you know, that's nothing. Okay, and then you'll be greeted with two options. You can either create a new MODX installation or create a Flex. What Flex is going to be is a new cloud will be created with like no files in it. So you can use it for like static sites or install WordPress and Drupal. Otherwise, should you do that when you can do, you know, when you can have MODX? So I want you to click on MODX. We're going to be installing MODX here. And here's the name of your cloud. And it can be anything. Now we're going to name it for baby MODX, but you can just name it Smelly Socks or something. It's not going to show up anywhere but in your MODX admin panel. So I'm just going to add for baby MODX, this is the name. And the name of our site is going to just be for baby. And the location, so input the location where your customers are going to be accessing your site most often from. So for example, if you are building a website for an Australian newspaper, just add it in Sydney. But if you're building a website, you know, how to find the best thrift stores in America, and you're an Australian and you're building it for an Australian company, then add the server in Texas. So make sure you add the server where your clients are going to be. So I'm going to use Dallas, Texas, and I think that's it. And you can also add it to a group. Now this is going to be in group blueprints, but I'm going to want to add it in another group called development. So they're nice and tidy. And now let's click create cloud creation. Okay, awesome. So our new cloud is currently being created, and you typically receive an email when it's done. It usually takes a couple of minutes. All right, now that our cloud is created, we have all the information we need. We have the cloud address and the web address. So you can use either one of those URL to access your site right away. Like, how cool is that? Then we have the version, which is the MODX version. This is not the PHP version. So MODX automatically installs the latest MODX version. We have the location, which is in Texas. We have the IP address, which we use later on to connect to a real domain. You have created on the date it was created, you know. Then we have our MySQL information, like the username and password. And then we have the SFTP SFTP information, you know, to connect to file 0 and stuff. And we have the name of the group. Then we have a couple of tabs. So we have the backups I told you guys about. And since I'm developing the site, I usually have it for like 7 days. But on live sites, I have it up to 30. And you have a limit of how many backups. Like, you have, if backups are heavy, you know, you're only limited to a number, certain number of storage. But the MODX Cloud is really cool about this, so I haven't had any problems. Snapshots, these are not important right now. And then domains. You know, right now we're using, you know, a development domain, but later on this will be, you know, a real domain. And then we have web server. We have here web rules rewrite. And what these are, it's like HD access, but the server the MODX Cloud is using is Nginx. So that, you guys, when I started developing a MODX Cloud, I was just banging my head against the wall while my HD access wasn't working. So they're not using HD access, they're using the Nginx, okay? And then you have your robots.txt, although you can edit them here, but just, you know, create a robots.txt and that'll be good. Then you have add-ons that you can, you know, add SSL certificates that provide free Let's Encrypt and stuff. So, and then you can add your NOM domains for more money, SDN, and then my PHP MyAdmin. I usually install this because I have to, actually, let's go ahead and install this because PHP MyAdmin is really good. And install location, always leave the funny name. Like, don't try to change the name to, you know, PHP MyAdmin because this folder will be able to be accessed from the web. And we want it to be, you know, as obscure as possible for defense in depth. You don't want, you know, people hacking your site and stuff. All right, and that's pretty much it. Now, reset PHP pool. I use this whenever my site goes down or if I'm writing PHP code and the whole site goes down, you know, I just reset the PHP pool and it's fine. So let's view our site. View our site, let's click here. View manager is if you want to go into the admin panel of the site. Now, the MODX admin panel is called the manager. So let's click view site and see how our site looks. And there you go, we have installed MODX. And that took like a minute. It's so easy with, you know, automatic install with the MODX Cloud. And unlike, you know, because usually shared hostings will have like, oh, one click WordPress install, one click Drupal install, but they do it so bad. They screw up the user permission so bad. It's so easy to hack a site whose CMS is automatically installed by the hosting. However, this one doesn't, you know, screw up your site, so that's good. So yeah, that's how you install MODX using the MODX Cloud. But like I said, you don't need the MODX Cloud. You can also install it manually on your own server, which I'm going to show you in the next video.